Some of you I do know or have met at some point in time. I just want to introduce myself again. My name is Kenesha. Please don't judge me by my hair right now. I feel precious. It left me a long time ago. But I am the coordinator for the Volunteer Post Voting Initiative that's spearheaded by the Montgomery Alumni Chapter of Delta Theta. And these is part of our canvassing list ahead of the election. I'm sure all of you are aware that our municipal election is going to be on Tuesday, where we have the power to elect our next mayor and our next city council. And I tell people all the time that local elections, local politics is pretty much local. Everything dealing from your livelihood within your district to the four bedrooms you may have on the street. The people that you elect in office for city council and mayor have control over that. So where we're going to go into Gibbs Village, which is public housing place, which has roughly over 500 tenants, I want to say. We're going to make sure that we go knock on every door and remind them that they do have an election on Tuesday, and we're going to offer rides on election day. That's one of our big parts of rolling to the polls. We pick up people from their homes, take them to go vote, and we bring them back to their house in our hub. We'll be actually here on Tuesday from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. So if you want to help call some people, help transport some people, by all means, you're more than welcome to come join us on Tuesday to help out. Before I go even further, please give a big hand to Cara McClure, one of the outreach coordinators for Black Voters Matter. You do have to burn Cara. Let me go ahead and say, in the last election, she ran for Public Service Commission. She's been a very activist, and I say she's one of those what I call hardcore activists. Any kind of injustice that you see going on, Cara has pretty much been there on the front lines fighting. And like I said, she is underappreciated, and we don't deserve her, so I just want her to make sure she get all the accolades possible here. And
not a whole lot. Alexis can piggyback. She's like, no. Let me just say thank you. Let's first of all, let's just give a hand clap for Miss Kenesha and Miss Carr. Because without them, like, Southern Youth wouldn't be here. And I know I kind of called you guys over the course of the last 4 to 8 hours, and we've been scrambling to get all of y'all here. And folks have driven from Auburn. Folks have driven from Painville. We've got some college students here, some college freshmen. So I'm really excited that you guys are excited about getting involved, considering the fact that this election is so crucial. This municipal election on Tuesday is so crucial to our futures, because a lot of us are all the same age. It's so crucial to our future and to what this city is about to be, and where we as a whole, as a people, are about to be. So I'm so thankful that you guys took time out of your Sunday and tomorrow, your Monday, because they'll be with us tomorrow.
Okay.
We'll be knocking on doors tomorrow. So thank you guys for taking the time out of y'all's week. I know y'all are getting ready for school. School has started. College has started. So I appreciate you guys. Thank you so much.
Yeah, and I mean, like, we really do appreciate this. And then to talk about how important this election is, in 200-year history, since the founding of Montgomery, Montgomery has never had a Black mayor. And Montgomery County is a predominantly Black county. We're 62% Black. So with 12 candidates running for mayor, 10 of them being Black, there's a strong probability that we will finally have our first Black mayor. But we also want to make sure that it's the right Black mayor that's going into office. So we're also making sure that we educate people, we encourage people to vet their candidates, to research the backgrounds of their candidates, make sure what they're voting for align with their issues. But we do have some people that are out here just saying anything to get elected, and people are not kind of, you know, going through the rhetoric. But we're not here to tell you who to vote for. But we just want to make sure people go and exercise their right to vote, especially when people have risked their lives and put their lives on the line to encourage people to vote. So that's going to be the crucial thing. So today what we're going to do, door to door, we're going to knock. Say your name. Please don't knock heavily like the police or the FBI, because we are going into the hood. It may not turn out right for you if you do that. So make sure you do like a little light tap. And let me say, these are some wonderful people. We campus out there with them all the time. And most of our rides that we give on election day come from this area. So they're very engaged. But we just want to make sure we just give them a little light tap on the shoulder, like, hey, don't forget where you need to be on Tuesday. So we're going to hand them their push cards. If they're not home, and we'll pass those out when we unload at Gibbs Village. If they're not home, we have door hangers that we can place on the door that gives the number and any kind of information they need to go vote on Tuesday. But this is mainly just a get out the vote tip. We are just going to remind people with a friendly face and to let them know that Black voters matter as we go out here and remind them to go vote. Okay? Are there any questions about anything? All hearts and minds clear?
It's Tuesday.
Tuesday, here, August 27th. Yes.
And they have the opportunity from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m.?
Yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And we're offering free rides. Okay?
And how will the shuttles work?
The shuttles work. We will have vans unpositioned that will kind of go around the district to pick up. But we also have a number where we have people that will drive their cars to go pick them up as well. Kind of like a bootleg Uber.
Yeah.
We may have some snacks, may not, I don't know. But it will operate in that same format.
You call okay. one number.
Yeah, you call one number and we'll just catch it out.
And that's on the pamphlet?
Yeah, that's okay. on the push cards. Where's Tyreek? You want to show the push cards that we have? So, yes. So these will be the door hangers that we have, and it has the number on the back for them to call. Okay? As well as, you know, description of what they need for a voter ID, because Alabama is still backwards where we have to have a photo ID, right? So, any other questions?
I just wanted to say to the fellas that's out here, while you're canvassing today, be tentative to the surroundings. Watch the ladies that'll be knocking on doors. Watch who's around you guys. Who passing you, what's going on? Because the world isn't as safe as it was. Early 50s and 60s and stuff.
Yeah.
So,
travel in pairs and make sure that we are in eyesight of each other. Don't, you know, just not saying that people are crazy, but there are some people in the world that are crazy. So make sure that we don't go inside anyone's home, you know, by yourself or anything. I mean, that's not to say that they'll do anything to you, but we just want to make sure that we're safely on our hands too. Do not have liability insurance. If something by chance happens to you, if you trip over a rock while walking, I can't go. But we can get you to the emergency. You can do that.
I'm a nurse.
Yeah, she's a nurse.
And I'm on CPR.
All right.
Y'all gonna be all right.
Yeah. We got
you got two nurses and CPR.
So she can help you and lay hands on you. Okay. So we're good. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna load up and we're gonna turn it on to Gia's Village. Are there any more questions before we get started?
Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. Lean on me, brother.
Vote is your voice. If they not out voting, they don't have a voice. They don't get to make any decisions on anything. Nobody cares about the non-voters that way. Look at how this is.
So
we need this. All right.
People here, I'm gonna say this right here. Y'all brought this to me, but let me say this here. There's a lot of Christian people that is being blessed by the devil, and they think it's the Lord. Check this out. You got men that selling drugs. They're going to church, and they got their girl going to church. She done joined the church. He bought her a car, bought her a house. She's standing in the top of wood. The Lord done bless me. Ain't no Lord when that old man is a drug dealer. Lord Satan, you feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Now, yeah. The earth is the Lord, it says. But this world is under the power of Satan. The Bible says that. You understand me? So that's why it's so hard for a real Christian to really come up unless you're doing something really on the side. You know. So y'all stay encouraged, huh?
Yes, sir.
Pay attention to your dreams now. Y'all know God talked to you about dreams too, huh?
Yes, sir.
Now you got your glasses on. Well, there's somebody else in this group here don't have their glasses on. In this group right here, huh?
I don't.
You ain't the only one. Somebody else up here on this group need some glasses, but they don't want to win.
I'm talking right here.
It don't have to be for the read. Sometimes you need glasses to read, some near-sighted, some foresighted. You follow me? All right? Yeah. So y'all be encouraged to help me. And when y'all pass these out, tell the people about Jesus too now.
Yes,
don't just make it about these votes. Feel me? Because when you lifting them up, you don't forget about the Lord. Am I correct now?
Yes, sir.
See? All right, y'all be encouraged, huh? Peace be with you guys.
First of all, I just want to say it's so many people out on a Sunday, and it's going really great. People are engaged. People are excited to make change on Tuesday, and we're letting them know that Black voters matter. All
right. Gonna do?
I'm gonna go vote too. So I got my t-shirt.
Alright.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Yeah, Phyllis can vote. I think you gotta go downtown or something like that.
Yeah, go to the probate office. They got the paper right there, man.
You can vote, man. Yeah. But you was in prison or jail, whatever.
You got a felon, so all you
got
to do is go to the
probate office.
Yeah,
you good.
Yeah.
Hey,
vote for Jermaine Brown.
You ain't
voting
for Jermaine Brown?
I know, man.
He crooked.
He crooked.
Oh, yeah. We want to vote Jermaine Brown.
Jermaine Brown. Run for mayor.
Yeah, that's right.
But you just asked me personally who I want to vote for. I
don't even believe y'all full black. You full black?
Yeah.
I'm full black.
You want to see the back of my neck?
I'm full. I'm half Indian, though.
I'm Native American.
You Native American? Yeah, I can tell you kind of Native. But you like you from Nigeria, because you see this? Look. Andre Lassie. I need government welfare. Food stamps. I need an extra $100 on my food stamp, because y'all fuck with me.
You said what?
Man, just tell them I said what's up, man. Y'all out here, we out here, we just posted, man. Everything going on. We gonna vote for everybody who ever got something going on. We gonna vote for them too. Tell them that.
Sure.
Let's break the fan over.
You don't wanna be on camera? Y'all ain't got people to vote?
Oh yes, we certainly do want people to get out.
All right. That's all.
Sweet to be the star.